Can we design a viral Halloween tee in 10 minutes using Kittl? Let's find out. I'm gonna take you through the whole research process and then how to create a prompt and then how to edit the whole design inside of Kittl to get it ready to upload to your platform. Create the design and the dimensions on Amazon merch, Etsy, your own website, or if you're using like third party print provider, or even if you're just creating a design to post on social media, let's get into it. Before we start designing, I always love to do research because I'm looking for a demand. And now I know that Halloween ghost floral shirt is doing pretty good because we spotted this trend a few months ago before it started selling. Well, and it started selling, and the next year we see like different design concepts, different ideas, and we know that it's doing really good. Now, if you're going to see right here, we can see monthly sales, 87. Got the ghost flowers, a little checkered background, right? Pretty cool. Another one, 10 sales, ghost with the flowers. Same thing over here, ghost with the flowers. Getting spooky vibes with this one over here, but we're looking for demand. There's that ghost over here again. We have a flower workshop over here going on with the ghost watering the plants. That's pretty cool. So we see that's doing good. When you're going to spot trends like this one, we know that this one's doing good. You're going to spot trends when they're happening and making sales. You're going to see that right away. This right here is mixing really well with Halloween. So something like this, we're going to go ahead and create this design right here and just get straight into the point and get an idea. So I want to create something that's probably this more, this one. I like this one a lot. This one's pretty cool too. This one's more bold and big and just more of like the graphics. Okay. Really no text or anything like that. You can add to that. Same thing with this one. I think we're going to go with something like this. And if you look a little bit more detailed into this, you're going to see 20 add to carts already. This is a really good sign. We're about a month and 3 weeks away from Halloween, and you can see there's reviews of this product already, which is really nice. And then this one, 20 add to carts too as well. You're seeing these price points. Just go ahead and pick a style, right? You're gonna see you picking the style, and then so we pick white, right? They're charging for shipping. So looks like it's going to be 21 and some change, 2160 or something like that. People are actually buying this design too. It looks like it's just a front pocket design right there. Nothing on the back. Very simple. Same thing with this one. We have 20 add to carts, right? You can see the price point right there. Let's pick a color and see if the price changes. We're charging $6 for shipping. Look at this, another one too. Two bought in the past 24 hours. That's a really good sign. That's one thing to pay attention to. Just because it doesn't have reviews yet or the 20 add to carts, but it's a newer product and it's starting to sell, that can be something trending, and you can leverage that idea by looking at this type of information and catching that before anyone else. And then you jump into the niche and you're making sales. You're the number one selling design in that niche. This is actually a pretty cool design too, because it has the flowers and stuff, the floral going on, but then it has a cool little pumpkin, the ghost in the flowers. Pretty cool. All right, now we're gonna use a mixture of ChatGPT and Kittl. If you're not unaware of Kittl, Kittl's gonna be down below in the description. I have a 25% off coupon. Use my link down there if you get value out of this, and make sure you smash that like button because it helps me. Okay, so I'm gonna come in here. I'm into my Kittl account. There's one cool thing too, to go over this real fast. You can create designs pretty fast. Just come over here into the templates and the type in ghost. So there's some pretty cool stuff back here. If you see a ghost that you like, leverage that. So you can see exactly, you'll come into some stuff, finding some good stuff. I find something, maybe just create extra design just for fun. But I think this is a cool idea to concept. If you're not leveraging this, I would leverage this part right here. Very powerful. So I'm gonna come over here into new project, right hand corner. We're gonna create the template for the Amazon merch on design. You can go whatever template you want on any of the sizings. You can edit any of this, which is really cool. Even the social media post you want to share with your audience, you can do that inside the mockup section too, which is really cool. So come over here to print on demand. I'm gonna go ahead and use the merch by Amazon t-shirt, 4500 by 5400, 300 DPI. Hit create, and then you're seeing we have some information over here, but we're gonna go ahead and use this Kittl AI ideogram 3 right here. So you can pick whatever one you wanna use here, but I'm gonna go ahead and use ideogram 3, the quality. And our image, this is where we're gonna use ChatGPT to help us with this. You can do this with the free version or the paid version. As far as this right here, I want a really good description of a design and get some inspiration for the idea, and hopefully it creates something really cool for us. And the other thing I'm doing too is I'm gonna take some screenshots and just generate prompt ideas for these designs. I took a screenshot of that one, gonna let that one populate. I'm looking for inspiration, different ideas. We're gonna plug it all in and use the AI inside of Kittl to help us create this trending design idea and give us more inspiration. You leverage all these elements, and it's gonna create something really cool for us. I'm getting vibes. I wanted to create something like this one, but I'm liking this style. What else can we do here? I feel like a witch's hat would be really cool on top of this design. This is more of taking the inspiration, getting the idea, getting the concept, and trying to create our own original idea from this. So that's the main goal here. So let's go ahead and grab one of these. Let's grab this right here. Let's go ahead and just grab that. Hit that, generate inside there.
So it's going to generate us an image inside of Kittl, and we're going to leverage that. We're just going to put them all here on the side of the canvas board. I'm trying to make sure that I create this video and keep it under 10 minutes because it's more of a design challenge for me. If you get any value from this, make sure you smash that like button for me. So we got all the four prompts done, okay? Don't get confused. Like, some of the designs that are created back here, I feel like sometimes they're just one-offs. They're going to be really good. All right, that one. That's an actual little pocket. Probably have to rework that one. That one's pretty cool because it's like a ghost pocket, right? I'm just getting the concept from here, but it's not actually the ghost pocket. So it just give us inspiration to create something like this would be more like the original idea behind it. That one's not bad at all. This is exactly what I was talking about right here. That's not bad at all. This one did a really good job at redoing that one. And it's coming to here. This is crazy because they're all pretty decent, right? Guess let's see what else it creates. Boom. Now, okay, I like this one as is right here. I'm gonna have to do the witch's hat on top of this. So I'm gonna have to edit this one. Add a ghost. All right, so it went ahead and reworked the prompt inside of ChatGPT. Now, it's like these prompts are so good that it's creating like the one-off inside of Kittl AI using different types of models you can use in here. But thank you. It did, and it's cool. And you may like something else, but this is just my opinion. Let me know in the comments which one's your favorite design. These are like one-offs. We're gonna click that. You can just bring it onto the canvas board if you want. Upscale it, vectorize it. What up to you? I'm gonna go ahead and upscale and remove the background. Looking pretty good. See that? The flowers are different. It's not exactly the same. If you want to, you can just bring over a different board. If you want to be completely different from all of them, okay, I think this one's more of that original one. That's the main goal. You want to be as different as possible. If you're copying this 100%, this one's already ranking, making sales. So this is always going to be above you. Your goal is to create a really cool design. Take the inspiration, take the idea from this main concept and see what's in demand. That's what we're doing. Taking that and coming over here and creating your own, okay, which is powerful. So it removed the background. And I'm just gonna go ahead and do this with every single one and give you an idea. We'll come back to this and show you how you can use my merch lister to help with the lister on Amazon merch. I plan on making one for Etsy too. Just a quick little update. It actually came out pretty good. Stars in the back, I think they're both good. Let me add some bats to the background. And a few things I wanna touch on as well. There's a whole different font library in the back end of Kittl, okay? There's like thousands and they keep on adding more fonts. You can even upload your own if you wanted to back here, okay? So there's a ton of different fonts that you can use. This one right here, I'm just messing around with and just looking at different fonts is the Sand Creek font. So it just says Happy Halloween. I can change anything from the color of the text. You can mask the text, right? So if you wanna put, let's say you wanna do like a floral over the text, you can do that too. And then the different graphic accents, color and contrast, texture and polish. So there's a ton of different things that you can do back here and make even templates for different designs. And there's even graphics, the textures too. Look at all the cool textures they have on the left hand side. Illustrations, you can see all the different shapes and you can even search anything. So if you want to search for a ghost, you're going to have different ghosts back here that you can use in the images. If you don't want to use their AI create, this is pretty solid. Another cool concept back here too, the mockup. Okay, so the design you can actually put on the mockup. If I click over here on the right hand side, it says mockup tools. Let's see if they got anything for Halloween. They got the Halloween stuff. Now let's say this witch right here. Just click on her. If you click on anything, it's basically gonna bring it over here. So the design is right there. And you like that mockup, just go ahead and you can download it. You can even change the color, which is cool. Look how cool this is, right? Download that one. Let's go ahead and do another mockup. If you wanted to change it to black, pretty clean, right? You can see that it removed the background pretty good too. You can download that. Now the concept behind this idea is I can post it on my social media and any of my friends like it. It's on my website, my Amazon merch account, my Etsy shop. It's on wherever. So I think I actually probably gonna do a few of these and just share it over there and see what people say. Good concept. And also too, just keep in mind, if you're building your own brand, push it out there, get it out to people. If you're not posting it, people don't know what you're creating. And if they don't know you're creating designs, how are they gonna buy it? Keep that in mind. Now, let me go ahead and show you this lister, this GPT that I created. It's called Merch Listing, Make Your First Sale. I'll put this down below in the description too. This one is free for you to use. If you haven't tested it out, I highly recommend because I'm gonna share an example. So let me go ahead and put one of those designs in there that we just created. I've been updating it all week and taking your feedback and all the information from people and understanding that and putting it in here to make it even better. If you have the paid version for ChatGPT, you cannot upload a design. You would have to describe it. I'll make a prompt to help you describe your design. So you obviously check for trademarks and copyrights, just making sure that you always do. That's very important. All right, so let me give you a breakdown. So I added the design. You can see exactly what it did. It created the brand, it created the title. And this is made with the intent of a buyer searching on Amazon. That's my main goal. The main goal of me making this GPT is understanding how a buyer was searched to find this design. As I'm doing a lot of this stuff, I'm refining it on the back end too. So you can see, you can get the idea. There's the title, you can see, and here's the bullet point one, bullet point two, and here's a description. The description's a little bit shorter, but I think it's okay. Let me know if you have any concerns or anything about that when it comes to this. But as far as doing all of this, it did the whole thing. And I usually have it checked for trademarks. This takes 2 minutes and 32 seconds. You can see everything it did, and it broke down every little detail. It's trying to avoid certain trademarks or copyrights and give you an understanding. This will teach you a lot. Pause the video, look at it. It will break down every single thing. Now, the next design did the same exact thing with this one. Okay, it's understanding the actual design, creating a brand title. And if you have, pause the video to watch this, and we'll break down everything because I'm going to resume past this. I don't want to bore you with this, but it's very important. But I'm doing pretty much all the back end work. Any feedback on anything that I'm sharing with you, or if you have any concepts, leave a comment down below, because I'm checking everything to refine and tweak everything with this GPT to make it the best GPT possible when it comes to Amazon merch listing. See the same thing, check for trademarks. It basically broke down everything. Next design, make a listing, boom, did everything right here. See the brand title, bullet point one, bullet point two, and description, and then check for trademarks. And I took those designs and uploaded them to Amazon Merch. And you're gonna see the designs are all uploaded. They're published. I'm gonna have those links down below in the description. So if you wanna check them out, make sure you check out those listings down below. And making sure that you always double check for trademarks, because you still gotta check for trademarks before you upload to any platform, because they have rules that they have to follow, and you have rules that you would have to follow if you wanna stay in good terms with your account. Now, hopefully this gave you an understanding. I tried my best to keep it within the 10-minute mark. There's a whole step-by-step process on how to do everything, but one thing is very important, is the research. Okay, you can catch a lot of these trending design ideas if you're doing consistent research before that happens, before all the competition jumps in on a niche. If you're continuously doing niche research every week, you'll get the idea and see the patterns before anyone else does, and you just jump on it. If you want to see how I create another design using Kittl, watch this video right here. Thank you very much for watching. Make sure you hit that thumbs up button and subscribe to my channel with notification bells on, because I'll be dropping weekly tips like this.